Now, when you go on a holiday, you want to return with fond memories of the places that you've been, the people that you've met, and the places that still accept travellers' cheques. Well, one woman hopes you also remember the hotel you stayed in, because as a hotel designer, it's her job to make them unforgettable.
Vee Kessner is responsible for some of the region's most exciting projects, and one of her most recent was judged best in the world. Carolyn Robinson decided to get some design tips.
It's a grand name, and now it's worthy of it. Built in 1928, the Grand Windsor was Auckland's first skyscraper at all of 10 stories.
It was very famous for its soda fountain tea rooms.
But the fizz went out of it over the years, and despite several incarnations, the building fell into disrepair. What it needed was a generous splash of cash and a cool head. Vee Kessner's a hotel designing specialist.
I love it, creating a unique space that you depart from your everyday life.
She's worked on some pretty exciting projects, but this Art Deco do-up was extra special.
It was lovely to reincarnate that old, tired building into something quite beautiful.
The predominantly concrete building had its challenges.
Drainage stayed where it was. There had been some long-term tenants in some of the hotel rooms, sleeping five or six to a room, so it was pretty gnarly.
And to cement that royal theme, she looked to the Windsor jewellery box for inspiration.
So we designed it on four different jewels: amethyst, tourmaline, sapphire and emerald, and applied that as a colour scheme within the rooms.
Might surprise you the lengths hotel designers go to get their ideas just right.
It's called a mock-up room, and generally they're done by clients who want to test the design so that when they get onto site and they're doing 150 of them, they've already worked out some of the more difficult aspects of the fit-out. We try to create a new experience in every hotel that you go to, and people are more savvy now when they travel. We've also got to deal with the likes of TripAdvisor and social media.
And guests don't just want fresh linen. Today's travellers want a story.
They need to have memorable moments. We see more and more that people wanting to create Instagram moments.
And the Grand Windsor created quite the global buzz.
It was entered into an awards program in London and won the best new boutique hotel in the world last year, which was very exciting.
It must be pretty hard to impress you in a hotel.
I travel a lot and I'm always staying in a different hotel. There's no good selling me a rewards program because I'm constantly looking at different hotels. I always learn something even from the most basic hotel.
New Zealand's Duchess of Design has taken the Grand Windsor from fading to five star.
Yeah, it's pretty special to see it finished, and I must admit, I do look at some of the comments on TripAdvisor just to see how people have enjoyed the spaces, because at the end of the day, for me, when you design a space, it's when people inhabit it and use it as it was intended where you actually have the joy of doing what you do.
Yeah, lovely spaces, but we never saw any shots of the buffet breakfast, which, quite frankly, is the most important thing about staying in a hotel.
Very important. I wonder if they do what they do at a lot of other hotels that I've been in recently, where they put aftershave in the air conditioning.
Really?
So, yeah, the hotel smells of a very fancy aftershave the whole time.
Oh, that's nice. Do you think they have soap on a rope at the Hotel Windsor?
Bound to.
Bound to.
Bound to.